left to right. So let us take this example. So first we need to scan from left to right. Okay. Now if the scan character is an operand, place it in the postfix expression. So we need to take a postfix expression as well as stat. So this is your stat. This is postfix expression. If the scan character is an operand, so now first we'll scan this b. So this is an operand. So in that case, we need to place it in postfix expression. So place this b in postfix expression. Next, if the scan character is an operator, say if it is an operator, then check if the stack is empty or not. And these are the conditions we need to go through in order to place this character if that character is an operator. So check if the stack is empty. Yes, stack is empty. So now go through this. A. If empty, push the operator onto stack. So our stack is empty. So you can push the operator onto stack. So second one is an operator. So you can push it onto stack. So if the scanned operator, if it is not empty, sorry, if stack is not empty, then check operator precedence. Say suppose here already stack is filled with plus, and if I get another symbol, another operator, then I need to go through the operator precedence. So if the scanned operator has more priority than topmost operator on the stack, so scanned operator means this one. And the operator on the stack is this one. So we need to compare these two operators now. So both of them are having equal priority. So these are the cases we need to write. So if scan operator has more priority than topmost operator on the stack, then we can push it. So scan operator, say suppose it is star, and the operator on top of the stack is plus. So we already know star is having more priority or precedence compared to plus. So you can push the star onto top of the stack. If priority of scanned operator is less than or equal to stack's topmost operator, say suppose if priority, so say I have minus, okay, then it comes under second one. If priority of scanned operator, so scanned operator is minus, if it is less than or equal to, so minus precedence is equal to plus, then in that case add it to the postfix expression. So then we need to add this plus to postfix expression if both of them are having equal precedence. Okay. And then after adding this, we can insert or push this onto stack. So if the scan character is open brace, okay, if it is an open brace, then push it onto stack. So if we have scan character as open brace, then you can directly push it onto stack. If scan character is closed, say I have scan character as closed after. So I have something like this. So first open brace and plus and then close brace. Then pop the stack until open brace is encountered. So if this is the case, then I need to pop all the elements in between this until this open brace is encountered. So between these two operators present in stack are only plus. So I need to pop this one. This and this. So until I encounter this open brace, I need to pop all the operators from stack. So if scan character is closed brace, pop the stack until open brace is encountered and discard both the parentheses. So you need to pop this closed one, open one, and we need to discard both the things. While we need to place only this plus in postfix expression. Repeat steps 2 to 5 until infix expression. expression is scanned. So we need to repeat steps from 2 to 5 until this complete input is scanned. So once scanning is over, pop the stack and add the operators in the postfix expression. For example, so scanning was completely done and these are the symbols which are left over on the stack. So after scanning all the symbols from till here. So see this, repeats once scanning is over. So after scanning all the symbols, pop the stack. So we need to pop leftover operators in stack and we need to insert them in postfix expression at the end of the expression until stack is not empty. So we need to do this until the stack is empty. Okay. Then print the postfix expression. So now the stack is empty. So we'll repeat this process until stack is empty. Next, print the postfix expression. Finally, we'll print the postfix expression. So this is the procedure for converting the given infix to postfix expression. So let us take this expression and solve and try to solve this with this procedure. So B plus C into A plus D. So initially stack is empty and this is your postfix expression. So first, if scanned character is an operand, so our character is an operand, so place it in postfix expression. Yes. Next, scanned character is operator. So you need to go through this third point. If it is an operator, check if stack is empty. So stack is empty. Now, if stack is empty, push the operator onto stack. So you can push this plus onto stack. Next input character is C. So again that is an operand, so you can push it onto stack. After this we have star. So here it is an operator. So go to point 3. So if stack is empty, so stack is not empty, so move to this B. If stack is not empty, you need to check operator precedence. So if the scanned operator has more priority, so star, this is our scanned operator. So check if this is having higher priority than topmost operator on stack. So yes, star is having higher priority than plus. So you need to implement this B1. If it is having higher priority, then push it onto stack. So push the star on top of the stack. Next input symbol is A. So A is an operand. So you can push A on into postfix expression. Then we have plus. Plus means again third point, operator case. So here if stack is not empty, operator precedence. So check scanned operator. Here we have plus. Check if plus is having higher priority than top of the stack. No, this plus is having lower priority or less priority compared to star. So we need to go to second point. If priority of scanned operator is less than or equal to topmost operator. So priority of scanned operator is less than topmost operator, then add it to postfix expression. So here we need to add this, pop this star and add it to postfix expression. Okay. Then again. So now what we'll do with this? Where to keep this plus? So here we need to compare. So we can't insert this plus here because plus and plus, both of them are having equal precedence. So again pop this plus and place it in postfix expression. So now stack is empty, so you can insert this plus onto stack. Next, last character is B. So that is an operand, so you can place it in postfix expression. So now scanning is done completely. See this, repeat steps 2 to 5 until Infix expression is scanned. Yes, it is completely scanned. Now, once scanning is over, pop this tag and add the operators. So once the scanning is over, you need to pop this tag. So all the leftover symbols in this tag should be popped out and they should be added at the end of the postfix expression. Okay, until stack is empty. So we'll add them to the postfix expression. Finally, print the postfix expression. So this is the final postfix expression. So what is the result? BC A star plus D plus. So this is the obtained postfix expression for this infix.